What's good for the goose is good for the gander.
The following has been rated PC for politically correct.
Pay attention, you just may learn something.
It's the Sage, Larry Elder.
But first, there's a very interesting article in the Los Angeles Times this morning called, and I quote, "How a liberal Santa Monica high school produced a top Trump advisor and speechwriter." And the article is about Stephen Miller, who has been chosen by Donald Trump to write his inaugural speech. Stephen Miller, those of you who've been listening to my show for a number of years know that he first started calling the show when he was a teenager at Santa Monica High School, a very liberal high school in a very liberal city. And Stephen Miller is a conservative and began to complain about bias. And he invited me to speak at his school. And it turns out that Stephen Miller had to jump through a lot of hoops to get me to speak there. And when I got there, Stephen Miller and I and a young man named Chris Moritz, who also was in the Republican Club at Santa Monica High, all of us had a meeting with the principal. The principal went over the speech and how long it was going to be and what the format was going to be. And I asked her whether or not other speakers who were liberal had to be offset by a speaker with a different ideology, because once they allowed me to speak, I found out that they were then going to bring in a liberal speaker later on to provide balance to the speech that they knew that I was going to give, which is fine. But I asked her whether balance was required for liberal speakers. For example, I knew that you had a union leader recently. Did you have a conservative on shortly after that to balance what she had to say? And the principal began to mumble and stumble. And there was another politician, a Democrat, left-wing Democrat, which is, of course, redundant. I asked her whether or not a Republican came in shortly after that to provide balance for that left-wing Democrat's speech. And again, she fumbled and stumbled. It became pretty obvious that I was being discriminated against because I was a conservative. But liberal speakers were not told, were not required to then be followed by a conservative speaker to balance the message that the liberal speaker had given. Obvious, another example of liberal bias. This article in the LA Times has a very interesting quote from a woman named Julia Brownley. She is now a lawmaker, but she was with the Santa Monica Malibu Unified School District. She was the board president. And in the article in the LA Times, she remembers Miller showing up at events in coat and tie, quote, "unlike any other student." And listen to this. Quote, "he had very conservative views, the exact opposite of what we were trying to accomplish in the school district." End of quote. I'm not sure Representative Brownlee is even aware of what she just now said. But here she is admitting that the goal was to create left-wing students. Quote, "he," referring to Stephen Miller, "had very conservative views, the exact opposite of what we were trying to accomplish in the school district." End of quote. Exact opposite of what we were trying to accomplish in the school district? Close quote. You're not trying to accomplish people that can read, write, and commute at grade level, people that can reason. You are trying to, quote, accomplish leftists. She all but said it. Now, if that doesn't tell you what's going on in our schools, I don't know what does. And notice how proud she was about it. Wasn't even subtle. Stephen Miller had very conservative views, the exact opposite of what we were trying to accomplish in the school district. Close quote. What they're trying to accomplish in the school district are Democrats, are leftists. are people that believe the rich get richer, the poor get poorer, of people who believe that the rich don't pay enough in taxes, of people who believe that global warming represents the biggest threat to the country, of people who believe that it is the government's job to provide this, to provide that, to provide this, to provide that, that racism, sexism, whatever ism that you want, are major problems in America still. And along comes Stephen Miller, who talks about rugged individualism, who believes in Article 1, Section 8, who believes the government is too large, who believes that this country was founded with certain principles that made us great. And this is, quote, the exact opposite of what we're trying to accomplish in the district, close quote, says Julia Brownley, who at the time was Santa Monica Malibu's Unified School District's board president. Miller was unlike any other student in that he argued against special treatment for immigrants and others. Oh my goodness. He had very conservative views, the exact opposite of what we are trying to accomplish in the school district. End of quote. Stephen Miller, after graduating from Santa Monica High, went on to Duke University, where he got involved in the school newspaper, and just as he did at Santa Monica, exposed the school for having left-wing values and views in the professor ranks. And then he went to Washington, D.C., where he started out as a staffer for Jeff Sessions from Alabama, worked his way up to a top staffer for Sessions. Sessions loaned him to the Donald Trump campaign, and obviously he's impressed Donald Trump to the point where Stephen Miller is now going to be writing Donald Trump's inaugural speech that he'll be giving on January the 20th. Pretty, pretty impressive. But for crying out loud, to have a former school board president admit that Stephen Miller, quote, had very conservative views, the exact opposite of what we are trying to accomplish, close quote, tells you everything you need to know about the mentality of our educrats here in this country. There is an organization called the National Association of Scholars, and they've got a chapter in California. And a few years ago, they put out a report that said the California colleges and universities, the state-run ones, had long since crossed the line from education into indoctrination. And I interviewed the chapter president, a man named John Ellis. And John Ellis says that these kids are not getting an education. They're getting an indoctrination. They, in essence, are being brainwashed. And this former school board president all but admitted that the goal was to create left-wing students. Not students who can think, not students who can reason and compute and write and do math at grade level. No, students who feel that they are aggrieved. Students who feel that America remains a racist, sexist, homophobic, troubled land in need of remedial intervention by left-wing Democrats.